Hello people, this is a V-Strom commuter moto vlog. Alright, I hate that radio voice, so that's all, you're not gonna hear it anymore. Okay, so today, again, is a wonderful fucking day. Look at the sky, man. Blue, turquoise, purpley, beautiful Sydney sky. But well, it's time to go to work. I'm praying there because this light sometimes doesn't turn properly for me. Look at the sound of my powerful V-Strom DL650 V-Twin. Again, we're here, you see how I point out the car on the left? So, ghosting people. Ghosting every single day, ghosting. If they can't see you, don't try to overtake. Don't die, please. Dying is not cool, and there's no coming back. For the people that ride their motorcycles every day, sometimes you wake up and the bike just happened to sound amazing. It's the right tone, I don't know, the combustion inside of the pistons and whatever. Sometimes it just sounds nice. I guess it has to do with the weather, with the temperature of the block of your engine and the exhaust pipe. I don't know. Besides that, this is an electronically injected bike, so I don't need the carburetor or anything, so here it is. Wow, that broom made my day in the morning. So here, I kind of accelerate to be on top of the pack behind me, coming from the red light, just so I'm the first one here. I said this before, but when they transform through three lanes into two, they take two lanes out, so it's kind of, I don't understand why it has to be so complicated. But it is what it is, and I guess it's just an inconvenience for a little amount of people. I gave way to that car to merge. That's why he kind of said thank you. So it's all good, people. You gotta leave your ego behind when you're on the road. This is all about making the flow of the movement smooth. That speed bridge is beautiful in the mornings. It's a bit cold today, but it's actually really nice. So here we go. I remember what happened today. I finally got to ride La S without any constriction. And I get to lean the bike pretty cool. So that was really nice, to be honest. I waited for that. To be clear, for I don't know how many days, 4 or 5 days already of my commute. So if you're always commuting in your bike, don't worry, you'll get the day when you have the road free for you, so you can enjoy the turns without thinking about the other motherfuckers killing you, you know what I mean? So here we go, La S, that's for you. What can I say? For somebody like me, for a dad like me, almost in my 40s, that was pretty fucking cool. I know Red Bull is not gonna want this part of my video to show some extreme maneuver, but you know, I'm just a daddy and I like it. So talking about daddy or not, I was wanting to talk about this for a couple of days now. For you guys and don't watch the fight, Daniel Cormier, DC, won the heavyweight championship of the world and became the only second person in the world to hold two championships at the same time. So he's the light heavyweight champion and the heavyweight champion of the UFC. For people that don't understand why this achievement is so big, it's because he fought somebody in a higher weight class than him. So in between his, look at this filtering, tight. I like it tight because you gotta lean the bike to make it go through. And the people in the cars are like, but I wanna see your Ferrari, the rightful indignation, the flim fell. Fuck you, get a motorcycle. Stop whinging. So, as I was saying, Daniel Cormier won the heavyweight championship. This guy is not an ordinary guy. He's 40 years old. He was an Olympian twice for the United States American team. In, yeah, two Olympics, I think Barcelona and something else. And he just started MMA less than 10 years ago. Just think, what were you doing 10 years ago? This guy started a brand new sport. Not far away from his origins in the contact sport. He was a wrestler. I don't know if grappling is considered a contact sport, but he already had decades of experience competing. So yeah, he became the champion, man. What were you doing 10 years ago? What was I doing 10 years ago? He started in his 30s, and before he became 40, he's a double champion. Imagine that. What a fucking inspiring guy. I know in AKA, America Kickboxing Team, he's a well-respected captain of the team, you know? So, man, you probably have seen his meme crying when he lost for the second time against John Bon Jones. You see, I let that car pass. Be courteous. Courteous doesn't make you less brave. So yeah, as I was saying, yeah, he won the championship, and he got two kids, man. One of the heartbreaking parts of his story is that he got a 5-year-old girl that died, a daughter, just suddenly died out of the blue. She didn't wake up one morning, you know. And he always talk about that daughter, and he's always so heartbreak, you know? And that guy, man, he lost a daughter, he lost the Olympics, he missed weight, he came back, and he won. So, what were you doing 10 years ago? Just think about it. So, here we go, we keep going in Military Road. It's not a very congested day, I think it's because we are in school holidays. So there's no parents taking kids to school, which is pretty cool. And you see how beautiful it is without all that traffic? Well, don't have kids. Haha! It's a joke, I love my kids, man. Kids, if you're watching this, doesn't matter what year it is, if you see your dad there, getting old in the couch, bring me a beer, okay? I made you. So yeah, always ghosting the trucks, always ghosting the cars in front of you. And I remember also, I got first in the red light in the merge to the Harbor Bridge Road. And yeah, I get to accelerate my motorcycle to the top speed allowed so I can merge safely. And it was really nice. Some people said this to me, and I think he was right. He said that the bus lane is like a red carpet laying there just for you, you know? And I think he's right. And I also think more people should be riding motorcycles, but, you know, it's also hard to break patterns, to break things that we're used to. But look at this, I'm first. Let's just enjoy these people. Little things like that make your day, man. Maybe you're riding your car and listening to the song that you like the most makes your day. So enjoy your cage and don't suck in traffic, okay? Just eat it like a cookie. We ride motorcycles. Ho! We're approaching the city now and we're gonna see the Harbor Bridge again. The Harbor Bridge. It's always such a beautiful sight, man. It's like your Mona Lisa in the mornings, man. You can just have a look at it and enjoy it. God damn it, my bike is sounding pretty good today. I don't know. Sometimes it just sounds right. Look at it. She's there, looking at you. Hi, Harbor Bridge. How are you going? My name is Ted. So, I was gonna say, for a lot of people, maybe crossing the bridge is a chore. But I don't know. For me, it's a sign of everything I fought for, you know? All the years I lost on my youth in this Australian dream, you know. And I'm finally here. I feel blessed. I feel like a lot of things have gone my way because of destiny or perseverance or just sheer luck, you know. But I enjoy it. It's windy. It's a bit cold always, but it's open up. It's like the opportunities are endless, and we're here just to take them. That's how I feel every time, every morning I cross a bridge. So I truly enjoy it. I hope you like it as much as me. I try to aim the camera to the ceiling of the bridge so you can see the mix of sky and steel. I don't know, it's just fucking awesome. And then you see all the skyscrapers in the back of the city while you accelerate through Team Cahill number one and Team Cahill number two. I couldn't take them plentifully today because there was some traffic. But as I said before, if you commute the same way every day, you'll get it for you one day. So don't worry, just enjoy it anyway, or learn what you can learn. Every day you kind of learn something new about the turns that you take on the road, like where the grip is on the ground where it's better to lean or not, depending on the camber of the road itself. So it's always nice. And here we go. That's the Opera House. Hi, Opera House. How are you going today? See any ferry yet? I remember I had that skier in front of me all the time, that billboard on the bus. So I just had to follow that bus for a long, long time, man. So just leave them a little bit of space and just enjoy, because you know that if this big bus is in front of you, not much is gonna happen. So you just have to, you know, linger in there and hope next time you don't get stuck in front of the bus again. People, I'm almost getting to work now. I'm very close. I don't want you to know exactly where I work because you're all freaks, and I don't need that. So, again, what were you doing 10 years ago? What do you want to be doing 10 years in the future? I heard something very clever today. I think it was Jordan Peterson. He said, for people to have a 15 minutes of fame, you need 10 years of perseverance. Just think about it. To get 15 minutes of fame, you need 10 years of perseverance. This can be applied to anything in life. Nothing comes without an effort, without a sacrifice.